Let us discuss the scope and nature of political theory as per O.P. Goba's book. A polity is an organization which regulates the members of the community. The term political refers to a polity. The state is an essential part of polity and enjoys a unique position among social institutions. The terms like polity, politics, and political are derived from the Greek word polis, which means Greek city-states. Today, the term politics is confined to institutions and activities which are in public domain. The term theory stands for systematic knowledge, and so political theory means systematic knowledge of political phenomena. Political theory is concerned with three types of statements. Political science is based on empirical and logical inferences, that is, based on sense experience and reasoning. Therefore, similar conclusions is possible through observation and reasoning. Moreover, the conclusions can be verified. Political philosophy is based on value judgments, that is, results differ between individual to individual or group to group. There is no reliable method of determining what is right or wrong, and also discovering scientifically the purpose of human life. Now, here we can clearly see the three types of statements. First, empirical. Second, logical. Third, value judgments. We can also see the difference between political science and philosophy. Political theory focuses on the study of political concepts and ideas with the help of normative and philosophical method. Political theory also focuses on the study of political institutions and behavior with the help of descriptive method. Thus, using proper method, political theory can be studied. Therefore, political theory cannot confine itself to scientific knowledge. It should also include values which exist in political philosophy. Political theory cannot ignore values on the grounds that values are biased or they have no logical structure, because through discussion or debate, a common principle can be derived to judge the validity of values. Political theory must include both political science and political. Let us see the nature of political science. Political science has adopted scientific methods and hence has adopted the following steps. First, observation, that is based on sense experience. Second, generalization, based on observation, a general rule can be established which can be verified through experimentation. A general rule can be obtained through inductive or deductive method. What is inductive method? Observation, pattern, hypothesis, theory. That is from particular to general. What is deductive method? Theory, hypothesis, observation, confirmation. That is from general to particular. Third, explanation gives reasons for the general rule, and this reason makes the situations meaningful. Fourth, prediction and prescription. With known facts and general rules, possible outcome can be known, and measures for achieving efficiency, satisfaction, etc. can be suggested. Behavioral approach uses scientific methods to study actual behavior of human beings in a political situation rather than explaining features of political institutions. Whereas post-behavioral approach emphasizes on revival of values without compromising scientific methods for the study of facts. Science experiments ke zariye padha jata hai. Usi tarah political science bhi scientific methods ko apna ke padhna chahti hai. और उन स्टेप्स के बारे में एक्सप्लेनेशन दिया गया है. बिहेवियरल थिंकर्स साइंटिफिक मेथड्स अपना के एक्चुअल बिहेवियर ऑफ ह्यूमन बीइंग्स को पढ़ते हैं, पर पोस्ट बिहेवियरल थिंकर्स का मानना है कि वैल्यूज को भी इम्पोर्टेंस देना चाहिए और वैल्यूज को साइंटिफिक मेथड्स के जरिए ही पढ़ना चाहिए. लेट अस डिस्कस द नेचर ऑफ पॉलिटिकल फिलॉसफी. पॉलिटिकल साइंस डील्स विद द रियल, व्हाइल पॉलिटिकल फिलॉसफी डील्स विद द आइडियल. दैट इज the former inquires into what is and the latter determines what they ought to do. The critical function and the clarification of concepts help us to understand the nature of political philosophy. Firstly, the critical function. D.D. Raffel observed that political philosopher like Plato, while depicting an ideal society, gave a critical evaluation of beliefs existing in society, which gives rational grounds for accepting or rejecting the beliefs. Secondly, clarification of concepts as observed by D.D. Raffle, concepts like society, law, liberty are general and also vague. Clarification of concepts involves analysis, synthesis, and improvement of concepts. Analysis of a concept leads to specifying its elements. Synthesis of concepts lead to logical relationship between the two concepts. Improvement of a concept leads to clarity of definition. Significance of political theory or importance of political theory or why do we need to study political theory? First point, control of social life. Political life needs to be scientifically analyzed in order to understand and solve problems of social life. Political science helps to understand the causes of violence in society and provides solutions for preventing violence. Political science helps in the development of society through human resources. Political science helps to find solutions to political instability and social crisis. Second, social criticism and reconstruction. Political philosophy is concerned with right and wrong, good or bad in social life. Political philosophers like Plato, Aristotle, Hobbes, Locke, Rousseau, Hegel, Marx have recognized the evils in society and also methods for social reconstruction. It is not possible to accept all their suggestions for social reconstruction, but we can draw valuable insights from their writings for finding solutions to the existing evils. For example, Plato exposed the ways and means of selfish and cunning politicians in a democracy. Third, clarification of concepts. Clarification of concepts is essential for the development of knowledge, but it is difficult in the field of political theory. Political philosophy helps in the clarification of concepts used in the analysis of social and political life. Thus, a precise and accepted definition of the terms like authority, liberty, equality, etc., enables thinkers to present their point of view. If there is no clarification, it can be misused by leaders or people to create emotional appeal or evade reason or to legitimize their oppressive regimes. As Mussolini, Hitler, Idi Amin, etc. Fourth, encouragement to mutual respect and toleration. Political theory through debates encourages us to understand each other's viewpoints. It gives an opportunity to identify the strengths and weaknesses in our viewpoints and convinces us to accept when truth is discovered. to conclude, as observed by Andrew Hacker, quote unquote, political theory is a never-ending conversation among theorists. And while the greatest of the debates are never resolved, the criticisms which the writers make are always vivid and illuminating. Thus, political theory encourages mutual respect and toleration and helps us to resolve differences in viewpoints amicably. Functions of political theory. The functions of political theory are as follows: description, criticism, and reconstruction. Political science emphasizes on empirical method. When knowledge is based on practical experience, it is reliable. Hence, it specializes in description. Political philosophy emphasizes on value judgment. Hence, it specializes in criticism and reconstruction. Advocates of positivism, neo-positivism, and behavioralism are of the opinion that political theory should confine itself to political science, because they argue that evaluative judgments are not reliable in determining what is right or wrong, and hence value judgment should be dropped from the scope of political philosophy. With the advent of post-behavioralism, there was a revival of values of political philosophy in the field of political theory. It has been observed that value judgment serves as a guide to social policy, and ignoring value judgment will leave society in the dark. Topics like environmentalism, human rights, social justice, etc. are in the domain of value judgments. As a result, political theory must not give up value judgments, otherwise politics will be in the hands of ignorant, selfish autocrats.